If you haven't figured it out yet, you can't go online and play multiplayer on the modded version. Not without the mod Be Together, which I believe is still in development. You can create and join lobbies with codes, but you can't do quick play yet. More on that in another video. I'm sure some of you who have been playing unmodded Beat Saber sometimes miss the multiplayer feature, but the whole process of modding again after playing online kept you from switching. If we have both modded and unmodded versions stored in the quest, we would not need to re-download Beat Saber or redo the modding process when we switch. With the app called Quest App Version Switcher installed in the quest, it's now possible to switch versions inside the quest in just a few clicks. How convenient! I think it's so underrated, and people who have been playing modded Beat Saber should at least know about it. So share this with your friends and hit that subscribe button below for more videos like this. Now let's get you set up. These are the requirements for Windows, Mac, and Android. If you need help in getting the requirements, check the description for my guides. For Windows and Mac, enter Quest App in the search box of SideQuest and sideload it. That's all you need SideQuest for in this tutorial, so you may disconnect the cable. For Android, using the Oculus browser, download Quest App Version Switcher from the website shown on your screen. Open CX File Explorer from Unknown Sources. Click Downloads and install Quest App Version Switcher. CX File Explorer acts as an installer of Android apps that you downloaded with any browser in your Quest, but it cannot install itself when you download it with the Oculus browser. That is why you need a one-time use of an Android phone to do the installation. Go to Unknown Sources and open Quest App Version Switcher. Loading may take a while on first launch, but that's normal. Click Allow. If nothing happens when you click Allow, just open the app again. As you can see, there is a downgrade tab here. You can also use this app to downgrade your other apps, not just Beat Saber. I have a guide in downgrading using the Quest App Version Switcher linked in the upper right corner of this video. In this step, we are going to do a backup of the current Beat Saber. So if you currently have the modded version installed, it will be stored in the quest in its modded state. This way, you can switch to it anytime without having to re-download anything or having to redo the modding process. In the Backups tab, you will see a text at the bottom that says Create a Backup of. It doesn't say what app. This means that you have not selected an app yet. Otherwise, it would look like this. To select an app, go to Tools and Options and click Change App. We are doing Beat Saber, so select com.beatgames.beatsaber. If it doesn't let you select, reopen the app and try again. On a rare occasion, it could take up to 3 tries. Go back to the Backups tab and create a name for your backup. My current version is modded, so I'm just gonna name it bs.modded, so I can easily identify which is modded and not. After that, click Create Backup. This won't take long and it will let you know when it's finished. Now you can uninstall the modded version and download the official one. After having installed the official Beat Saber, open it first. Create your avatar so that it will be saved with a backup and you won't have to make your avatar again when you switch. And if you want some settings changed like the player height, you should do it now too. And don't forget to re-download your paid music packs. And play one game on solo mode and just let it fail. It's time to create a backup of the official version. Scroll down a little bit to see the status. Now you have both versions stored in your quest. it's time to switch. To switch to a version, select the backup and click Restore. You can look at the Restore button as your switch. The first time you use the Restore feature, you'll have to give Quest App Version Switcher permissions to install apps. During the installation, there's a chance you'll get this message, but don't worry about it, it won't affect the progress. Just click Wait. And that is how you switch. Let's check Beat Saber. If your custom songs don't appear in-game after the switch, go to BMBF and click Sync to Beat Saber. And if you want to add more custom songs to Beat Saber after restoring, you need to restart your headset before attempting to do so. I hope this video helped you, and don't forget to subscribe and leave this video a like.